And we've replaced them, placed the lead dog in the pack with myself. So therefore, what she does, she goes out and gathers the animals, which would be her prey in the wild. And she gathers them up and brings them along over to the lead dog, in this case me. So I get to choose which sheep I want, and she gets to eat her dinner. And that's the basic principle of herding. All she's doing is really what she does naturally for the sake of food. So that's why food rewards don't work with dogs like this. Lots of people get their dogs to sit and stay and stop and all those things using little food rewards. My dogs look at me and go, but I've got a whole sheep to eat. Why would I want that little tip that you're going to give me? So we have to use other principles of training. So we use their natural instinct to help them, and the great reward they get is to herd sheep. And they'll do whatever you want them to do, provided they get to herd sheep. And so we use that great innate ability or instinct to help us with our training. It's a fairly basic principle. It's about getting them to move in one direction. It's about getting them to move in another direction. It's about getting them to stop if we can. She sort of stopped, didn't she? Didn't quite stop. And we get her to walk up on her sheep or push them along. And we also get them to back off. Now, Floss doesn't quite back off yet because she's still young in her training. But some of the older dogs, just like joystick commands, we get our dogs to go left, right, backwards and forwards, which allows us to put our dog wherever we want, and that will direct the sheep in whichever we want. So if you can see those principles, if I get it to go in that direction, it's just a matter of walking because the balance makes her do that. She pushed that sheep pretty hard then. The balance makes her do that. The balance makes her do that. And then we put a command to it. As she's doing it, we make a noise. And in my case, I use a whistle. As she's doing it, I make a noise. Again, a whistle. And she'll associate that movement with that whistle and start to work like this. When I say nothing, she goes back to doing what she does naturally, which is balancing sheep or fetching sheep. So by teaching them to do that, we can stop that dog at any place around the clock face, have them walk in, and have them take sheep wherever we go. Then we can get some jobs done. So if I see a younger dog in her career, she's just starting, we've got some more experienced dogs in here, and with these sheep being quite heavy and quite tight, we don't need something a little...